GIFTpreneurs, episode 6. Let's talk about jobs and the transformation that's underway right now. The majority of the world has no clue what's going on. And so, my name is Mike. Welcome back to GIFTpreneurs, episode 6. And so excited to continue to build upon just sharing with you the importance, like never before, to begin thinking beyond your job. And so today I want to actually do something a little bit different. Want to share with you some information that I believe is very eye-opening, given the fact that unless you are actually looking and studying and researching and looking to stay ahead of the trends, you can find yourself becoming a victim of trends that are already underway. And so I want to share with you a interview done by a billionaire investor by the name of Kai-Fu Lee. He's a best-selling author, and I actually came across Kai-Fu Lee sometime, I want to say over a year or two ago, because I like to study trends. And so the best way to predict the future is to see who is attempting to create a future and to disrupt the current paradigm that's underway now. And a part of the GIFTpreneur is to help people understand the fact that there are already things in play that will shake up your world in one form or another. And I'd imagine if you were aware and you knew that change was underway, you would want to do something different. So that's what the whole GIFTpreneur is about. It's about helping people think beyond their jobs, helping people realize that they're carrying something that is just as uniquely valuable to the world as their current thought process around their jobs. And so listen to this interview here by Kai-Fu Lee, and then you have a better understanding of where I'm going today. And then also, for those that are probably listening via podcast, you might want to check this out on YouTube, because I'm going to do a little drawing demonstration for the first time to give you an actual visual aid as to how this all interconnects to you and the importance of finding your gifts or your area of uniqueness to begin serving directly for yourself outside of your job, as long as you have a job. Because according to this information here, the way things are being set up, it's not likely that the current style of employment that we have now will be the case for much longer. And so listen to this interview here, and then we'll get into it.
Lee is much more talkative about another threat posed by AI. He explores the coming destruction of jobs in a new book, AI Superpowers, China, Silicon Valley, and the New World Order.
AI will increasingly replace repetitive jobs, not just for blue-collar work, but a lot of white-collar work.
What sort of jobs would be lost to AI?
Basically chauffeurs, truck drivers, anyone who does driving for a living, their jobs will be disrupted more in the 15 to 20-year time frame. And many jobs that seem a little bit complex, chef, waiter, a lot of things will become automated. We'll have automated stores, automated restaurants, and altogether, in 15 years, that's going to displace about 40% of jobs in the world.
40% of jobs in the world will be displaced by technology?
I would say displaceable.
What does that do to the fabric of society?
Well, in some sense, there's the human wisdom that always overcomes these technology revolutions. The invention of the steam engine, the sewing machine, the electricity, have all displaced jobs, and we've gotten over it. The challenge of AI is this 40%, whether it's 15 or 25 years, is coming faster than the previous revolutions.
So there you have Kai-Fu Lee giving an interview, and a lot of things stood out to me that I want to touch on. And so Kai-Fu Lee, as I mentioned, he's a billionaire investor. So if you happen to Google Kai-Fu Lee, you'll get a chance to find out more about this young man. But yet he's heavily involved, very happily excited about disrupting the current paradigm from an entrepreneurial business standpoint. But yet he specializes in investing in firms that create what's called artificial intelligence, or computer algorithms that's designed to utilize the data that's currently being gathered by Google to Facebook to Amazon's. All the activity you have on your smartphones is being gathered to make artificial intelligence or the software programming operate smoother and more efficiently, along with the incorporation of robotics or whatnot. So that's kind of just a nutshell. It goes a lot deeper than that, but just to give you something to begin thinking about. And so one thing that really stood out is that he mentioned that he predicts within the next 10, 15 years, give or take, that there'll be 40%. 40% of jobs will be displaced. And therefore, that means that a lot of blue collar as well as white collar jobs are at risk at this current moment. And one of the biggest things that really has me somewhat concerned is the fact that outside of this stuff that's already going on now, the educational system, as far as the preschool all the way to your master's degree type of educational information that's being shared, has not really adapted or changed much over the last several decades, definitely last, you know, probably century, of encouraging children to get the basic information to then go on to specialize through higher learning and to take on a skill set that in this new economy that's being created for us may not be as applicable as it was in the old. And so one of the issues that's going to take place, the fact that the educational system is not currently keeping up with the increase in technology. And so outside of the disruption of the current jobs we have now, whether it be, as you mentioned, truck drivers, waiters, servers, all the lower labor and skilled type jobs, then you're going to have the more disruption in the higher skilled jobs, such as doctors, lawyers, even engineers, and all the jobs that are currently looked at as desirable because they are 6-7 whatever figure type jobs are all going to take are going to be shifted real soon. So I want to get into today's podcast and basically lay out something and draw up a couple of things where I believe by the time I'm done here, hopefully you'll understand the importance of taking the current position you're at right now, wherever you're employed at, whatever you're doing now, and using that for your benefit long term. Because between now and the time your company or whatever business you work for, by the time they pick up the trend and the need for them to implement some of this technology, there's going to be some massive downsizing. And so as always, I've always talked about the amount of layoffs that's occurring daily. And it's one of them things where it's just a natural evolution of technology continuing to improve. Therefore, there's going to be shifts. And my biggest thing is I want you to be warned. I want you to have a heads up and already have a game plan as to how you're going to utilize this technology for your benefit or not be caught off guard by it. And so as you guys can see, I want to actually share with you some stuff here on the screen. And so the current paradigm we have now is it's fairly simple. It's designed to basically you go to school, you get a job. So we have you right here, the person, and you go to school, you get a job, you get a certificate at the end of it, and you're told that now it's time to enter the workforce. So the workforce might be whatever particular skill that's, you know, that probably entices you via compensation. So everyone wants to go to school to pursue a career, to get something out of it. Ideally, a paycheck so that you can start your life, so that you can set aside something, retire, and all the things that come along with that. And so with that model, you have to be, you're usually employed by a corporation. And if you can get into a top 500 organization, you're doing great and you're successful and all the things that come along with that. But yeah, here's the thing. A lot of people don't understand the employment concept, and employment and or having a job is only as beneficial as on the end of all the work and all the intermediary parties. If they're able to produce a profit, then it goes well. But the moment they're not able to receive a profit, there's problems. And so at the very end of your job, so say, for example, you have a job for a top 500 company. And then along with that, in that company is made up of, you got HR, you got the actual labor force, you have the board of executives, you have all the other different chains that go along with that. And at the very end, you have at the end of all this, you have the consumer. So whether they're selling directly to the market or a subsidiary or a service sector, whatever, you have this long chain of events that takes place from the time you enter your workforce to the time you leave. And at the very end, you have the customer. And so this current model here is being disrupted as we speak, because technology is making it very easy for a lot of the things in the middle to be replaced. And so not only HR department, you have the actual hands and labor that puts this, that puts stuff together, assemble stuff, drive the places to people, answer the phones, all this stuff right here in the middle that's being disrupted. So what that means is that the board, these people right here that make all the decisions on how much money is made in the company, they are now saying, hey, we have to cut back. Why? Why are they want to cut back? So if you look around and you can kind of get a sense of where the economy is at right now. The economy as a whole is not as strong as it has been in prior years. Therefore, when you have two contracting quarters, and so that's all on the financial side of things, you have something which is going to be called a recession. And every recession brings shift. Every recession brings change. And the problem is this current economic slowdown is underway. The biggest fear is that this recession here will not just be your ordinary recession like we've had in the past. So what does that mean? That means that companies right now, and so if you just Google layoffs, you Google downsizing, you're going to see all types of companies that are in the process of making changes. And so what does those changes look like? Basically, you have companies that are deciding to utilize technology in the form of AI and robotics to alleviate some of the things in the middle. Some of the things in the middle happen to be the actual people who get up and do the most of the hands-on work. The middlemen, which happen to be employees, those that are dependent upon, as Kylie said, repetitive jobs that don't require much skill or can be outsourced or can be automated. And so those people are standing to lose the most. And so the whole idea of Giftpreneur is designed to help you to understand that employment, to me, in my personal opinion, and that's where I'm going to get into this a lot more in the future, is employment was not designed to be the beginning and the end of your entire life. And so we've been conditioned to think that from the time you enter the workforce until the time you are automatically forced out around the concept of retirement, all that right there is in the process of being changed. Because imagine if there is no employment, if there is no career pathway that you can climb or no corporate ladder that you can climb, what's the likelihood of you being able to retire at the end of that 40-year window successfully? What's the chance that you've been able to actually have a complete work life from beginning to end and there not be some disruption? And right now you're being told that they're designing and setting up technology so that corporations can be more profitable. Therefore, who's going to be cut out? It's going to be employees. It's going to be those that are solely dependent upon selling their time and labor and skill for money. So those people who solely do those three things there, which is what our educational system is designed to teach us to do, those people will be shocked into a whole new reality of change. And so what I want to share with you guys here is the fact that you hear that people out there are deliberately trying to shake up the industry. They're shaking up everything. And how does this shake up apply to you? It's simple. If you don't begin thinking beyond your job, if you don't begin thinking on how and what your overall purpose is in this thing called life, you're going to be one of the individuals that will be faced with the reality of, like, your service is no longer will be needed. And so one of the biggest issues that mankind has is that our self-worth and our value comes from what we get up in the morning to do and in the form of work. And so work, as I've mentioned in prior podcasts, is just a simple act of two things. It's you expressing yourself and becoming yourself and you exerting energy towards some long-term objective. And so the long-term objective, according to the employment model, is that you get up, you put in your time, you get compensated for it. And then we've been told that once that window is up, you can then retire. And so if this job disruption technology is coming, that means the chance of you being able to have a 34-year career climbing a ladder, trying to become everything you can within a company will be challenged because, as you're going to see with the introduction of AI and robotics, human labor will no longer be needed in the way that it has in the past. So what does that mean? The employment model will change. And so it's going to change because employment has a time window on it. And so that time window is the time you enter the workforce to the time you leave 30, 40 years later through retirement. All that time frame, all that time put in is going to be different. There will no longer be the idea of holding one single job, nevertheless 5 to 10 to 15 jobs if AI and robotics take over. So the typical employment pathway has already changed, and hopefully you can see by now how that is changing. So where would that leave us? Why is it changing? It's simply because businesses, so say top 500 businesses, still want to they still want consumers at the end. They still want customers. That, and that's the whole point of being in business, is to make a profit at the expense of anybody's personal interests or whatever. That's not one of the primary concerns of your boss, is to make sure that your lifestyle is comfortable and you're good. It's more so he has a job, and it's primarily to return profits back to the shareholders. That's just how business operates. And so what they're doing, they're cutting out the middleman, which means hands-on labor, people, skill, time. They're minimizing that right now as we speak. Just Google it for yourself. You understand what I'm saying. What are they replacing it with? AI and robotics. And there will be minimum, at the very minimum. Every company's going to find out how much they can get away with the least amount of actual human labor, apart from what they need. Why? Because it's so much easier to have a robot and artificial intelligence through algorithms, computer systems, and whatnot, to do all the heavy lifting and repetitive actions over and over again. So the model of employment is gone. We're in the world of AI. Where does that leave you? In the midst of this change, between now and the time that your employer or your boss or whoever decides to hand you a pink slip, I believe it's important for you to start your life's plan. And this has a lot to do with the giftpreneur concept. It's my personal opinion that God did not put us on this earth solely to work a job and then to retire, which is to remove ourselves from the workforce and then begin living our dreams. And so right now, having a dream that you are pursuing and also having an idea as to what it is you want to contribute will be your best investment in this current decade moving forward because of what's going on. And so if you have yourself here, you have something that you're carrying in the form of a gift, and that gift is designed to be an idea for something that you're supposed to serve directly to the world, i.e. customer, or simply saying just service. So you have the old model of employment, you have the shift into AI, and then you have you there all along. And so it is very important, in my personal opinion, that you begin thinking beyond your job. And it starts with simply finding out what it is that you desire to serve to the world. Who do you desire to serve? What do you desire to serve? How will you get it done? Those are all things that I believe you're responsible for finding out. And it plays right along with fulfillment and pursuing things that will make a difference, not only in your life, but more importantly in others' lives. And so the reason I wanted to make this podcast today was just to shine some light on some disruptors in the industry. Right now, the current paradigm is changing. The coming destruction of jobs is well underway. A majority of the world has no clue as to what's going on. And especially here in the developed world, if you're in the United States of America listening to this, then you know that something's not right. You have a friend, you have a cousin, you have somebody that's close to you or not too far removed from you that's experiencing some employment difficulties. And so it's just a matter of time before it trickles on down through the rest of the economy, because as long as the economy, quote unquote, is doing well, then employment won't be a problem. But the moment it slows down, like it always does, there'll be a shift. And as I mentioned before, the difference with this current shift is that we've been in a 10-year expansion of a lot of things being done in the financial realm that will be hard to explain in this particular podcast here. But it's a lot of things that have artificially propped up the markets, propped up a lot of companies right now that's heavily indebted. Therefore, the moment that those bills are due and those companies aren't able to make payment, then what does that mean? They're going to be looking to trim any way they can. And the first and the last line of importance for a company in this current moment because they're heading into the artificial world using technology will be human labor, i.e. those that are solely dependent upon employment and jobs. So I couldn't stress this, the importance enough of you thinking beyond your job, thinking more so towards what is your contribution, what is your gift. And so then this goes back to the spiritual elements of things, because as I mentioned not long ago, it's my personal belief that God has something a lot greater than what we can even expect for ourselves. But due to this current paradigm, we've been lulled to sleep in thinking that your education alone will provide you a skill set that will always pay your bills. And in the days ahead, as AI takes over and more jobs are lost, along with the creation of a lot of new jobs, there's going to be that window of time where you might find yourself on the outside looking in and in need of something to grab a hold of. And that's why I think it's very important now for you to get connected with a community of people that have same interests to you, similar interests as you, so that you can uncover a little bit more about yourself. And I believe that your seed of greatness, which happens to be within your gift, which is what you are inherently carrying now, can be something that can begin opening up doors for you at this current moment if you really understood the importance of diving into that stuff now. So I thought I would just share with you some information to further play along with the idea of the changes that's been going on for quite some time now, because I've hinted on them in prior podcasts. But the coming job disruption is currently underway, and I want to make sure no one's caught off guard. No matter how well you're doing in life right now, no matter how secure things look, we're entering to times where there will be no such thing as security. And so the only confidence you can have is in what you're carrying yourself, because once you uncover, define, and release who you truly are, I believe that the world will recognize it. And once you are deploying yourself directly into the marketplace, then you'll find out the true value of what it is you're carrying. And therefore, you'll always have something that the world expects from you and that the world is needing from you, which will be an opportunity for you to protect, provide, and to preserve your own uniqueness and to be able to sustain yourself outside of just depending upon someone else employing you and providing a job for you. So that being the case, I wanted to keep this quick and short. Hopefully this was informative. Hopefully you got a chance to see some of the things I've been mentioning in prior podcasts about employment and where it's heading. This is just one particular angle. I have a couple more I'm going to bring at you, all leading to the fact that we're going to dive further into the how-to of getting into the gift side of things to give you some practical steps day-to-day that you can focus on. But more importantly, if you're a believer in Christ, it starts with you getting before your maker, the source who's giving you those unique areas of gifting that you're supposed to deploy, and begin finding out from him directly what it is you're supposed to contribute to humanity. And I think in doing so, it'll prepare you for the steps ahead in a future podcast where we're going to dive deeper into that. So that being the case, want to cut it short right here. Hope you guys enjoy this. If you have, definitely get us a thumbs up if you're watching this via video. If you're watching it on podcast, definitely share your thoughts and comments. Give this a good review so this podcast can rise up to the top, so more people can find out about what's going on. Because once again, there's not many places where you're going to get truth such as this about what's happening in the economy tied in with the core importance of having some spirituality and having God on your corner, in your side, to help see you through this. Because once again, I'm extremely excited, because in recognizing the change, I see great opportunity for myself. And it starts with being able to help a lot of people. And I believe that this type of message here will be of extreme value as time moves on and people begin looking for answers to the problems that were there in front of them all along. So that being the case, look forward to bringing you more podcasts. Enjoy your day. Remember, your gift will make room for you. So find out what that gift is, and I think you'll always be fulfilled as you find your purpose. See you later.